Here at Lumafield, we designed the Neptune CT scanner to be easy enough to use so that anyone can produce high-quality scans with minimal training. Hi everyone, my name is Caitlin and I work with the hardware team here at Lumafield. Today I'm going to walk you through some basic steps for how to set up and run your own CT scan. The scanner is operated using a touchscreen interface over here. If you haven't run your machine in a while, you'll be prompted to condition the X-ray source. Conditioning the X-ray source helps maintain the health of the X-ray source and improves the quality of your scans. So I'm going to make sure that the door is shut and then press the Begin Conditioning button, which will automatically start the conditioning process, which takes anywhere from 15 to 30 minutes. If you haven't run your CT scanner in a while, you might want to home your motion axes to improve the spatial accuracy of your system. Once the source is finished conditioning, check to make sure that there's no parts inside the machine. Click the Unlatch button to unlock the machine and then open the door by sliding it open to the left. This gives you access to the main chamber. In the middle, you'll see the main scanning platform, which is where you'll place the object to be scanned. The X-ray source on the right will shoot X-rays through the object to the detector system on the left. Materials that are denser or thicker will block more X-rays than materials that are thinner or less dense. Throughout the duration of the scan, the scanning platform is going to rotate 360 degrees so that we can capture X-ray images from a variety of angles. You'll also have the ability to move the scanning platform both horizontally and vertically when setting up your scan. Moving the object closer to the X-ray source will zoom in or increase your magnification. Moving the object further from the X-ray source will zoom out or decrease your magnification. I like to think about this as if there's a light bulb on the right side of the machine shining onto the object and casting a shadow to the left side where the detector is. If you move the object closer to the light bulb, it'll cast a larger shadow. To start, I'm going to place this toy car on the scanning platform and try to keep it centered, keeping in mind that it's going to rotate throughout the duration of the scan. Next, we're going to center the object vertically relative to the X-ray source by moving the slider over here to bring it into the field of view. In order to see where the object is in the field of view, we're going to want to turn the X-rays on, which will require closing the door. And then we'll press the scan button to turn the X-rays on. The X-rays might take a while to warm up, but you can see the image of the object here on the screen. Next, we're going to want to position the object so that it's not clipping like it's showing here on the right. So to do this, we're going to zoom out and then the image will automatically update to show what's being captured on the detector. Run a vase scan, which will take sample images of the object at different angles to make sure it's still within frame. On this page, you'll also see a number of scan parameter settings, such as beam energy, current, gain, and exposure time. These are all settings that you can use if you're an advanced user who wants to have more control over your scans. But for most users, we actually recommend using this auto scan functionality, which allows the machine to figure out the best parameters for your scan. The main variable you can control is scan time, which corresponds to scan quality. A faster scan will take fewer images and will give you a coarser end result. A slower scan will take many more images and will give you a higher resolution end result. After running a few scans, you'll start to get a better idea of how the different settings correspond to different scan qualities. If you're scanning a lightweight plastic part, you can run a scan in as little as a few minutes. But if you're scanning a thicker steel part, you might want to run the scan overnight so that you can get finer resolution details. Now we're going to hit the auto scan button, which will start the scanning process, and the scanner will pretty much take care of everything for you at this point. The first thing that the scanner is going to do is it's going to run its auto-tuning process, which will start optimizing all those scanning parameters that we talked about earlier. Then the scanner is going to take a few blank images, which will be used to remove any artifacts. It will then run the scan and upload the data to our software, which will then reconstruct it into a 3D model, which will be available for viewing and analysis in Voyager, our cloud-based software. And that's all you need to do to be able to run a scan.